Good morning, everyone. I would like you to take a moment and just close your eyes. Picture someone who is addicted to drugs. What do they look like? How are they behaving? What is their life like? Okay, you can open your eyes. The common perception of people afflicted by drug addiction is that they're inherently immoral and weak people who are governed by impulse and often thought of as dangerous members of society. Well, today I'm going to challenge this perception and hopefully change the way you think about drug addiction. So although we're still battling the stigmatization of mental illness, people with drug addictions face even greater discrimination. In a recent study, a sample of adults were surveyed to compare their beliefs about mental illness and drug addiction. When asked about mental illness, the majority of the respondents felt comfortable working with those afflicted by mental illness, supported government spending on mental illness treatments, and perceived the stigma surrounding mental illness to be a problem. But when asked about drug addiction, the majority of respondents did not have these beliefs. In fact, only 38% of the respondents believed the stigma surrounding drug addiction to be a problem. Well, I'm here to tell you that it is a problem, and here's why. So clearly, drug addiction is associated with mass public stigma. And because of this stigma, people with drug addictions tend to resist treatment in fear of being labeled a drug addict. And so over time, they begin to internalize the stigma, attaching negative stereotypes like dangerous and immoral to themselves. And because they perceive themselves as feared and rejected by society, they isolate themselves. To make things worse, this social isolation actually promotes further drug use. So clearly, stigma inhibits recovery, and we need to do something to stop this vicious cycle. At the root of the problem is the tendency for our society to perceive addiction as a moral issue. We attribute the problem to the individual, like it's their personal factors that are causing them to abuse drugs. The addiction is perceived to be a choice, and this choice has a consequence, punishment. This general mentality leads to government policies that encourage a war on drugs. However, these policies are costly and have failed time and time again to combat drug addiction. For instance, just 2 weeks ago, a group of Detroit police officers raided and actually physically fought what they thought was a group of drug dealers. In reality, it was a group of fellow police officers who were merely posing as drug dealers. And now, although the situation is somewhat laughable, it paints a picture of how poorly drug addiction is currently handled. So, what's the solution? One alternative is to reframe addiction as a brain disorder. Here, the problem is attributed not to the individual, but to society, because it's situational factors like social isolation that lead someone to abuse drugs. The addiction itself is due to physiological changes in the brain, and because it's biological in nature, it can be treated rather than punished. So when someone takes a drug, whether it be nicotine, marijuana, heroin, it activates the reward circuit in the brain. Here, the ventral tegmental area, or VTA, stimulates the nucleus accumbens, which is a brain region responsible for reward and motivation. So when the nucleus accumbens activates the prefrontal cortex, a brain region responsible for controlling behavior, this signals to us that the behavior is rewarding and should increase in frequency. These brain regions communicate through chemical signals called neurotransmitters. And more specifically, the VTA releases a neurotransmitter called dopamine. Dopamine acts kind of like a learning signal to reinforce pleasurable behaviors. So behaviors like eating food or having sex naturally elicit this reward response where dopamine is released. But drugs, on the other hand, alter the reward pathway to produce an abnormally large dopamine surge, which indicates to us that this behavior is especially rewarding. But over time, the brain begins to adapt. Our brains compensate for this overload of dopamine by becoming less receptive to dopamine, which makes the reward circuit more difficult to activate. So the individual starts to need the drug to achieve a normal level of reward or just to feel normal. And after enough drug exposure, there can be long-lasting changes in neural circuits, which is why addiction can be so difficult to overcome and why someone shouldn't be considered weak if they relapse. So, okay, we get it. Neuroscience can be used to explain addiction, but can spreading this knowledge actually help to reduce stigma? Well, in a recent study, a group of people were interviewed on their beliefs about addiction, both before and after telling them about this brain disorder model. And after this explanation, about 75% of the people changed their views, where over 50% empathized with people afflicted by drug addiction considerably more. So today, many countries not only ostracize people with drug addictions, but criminalize them. And this promotes stigma while inhibiting recovery, thereby failing to solve the problem at hand. By treating addiction as a brain disorder, we're taking a step towards implementing better policies and discovering more effective treatment strategies. But to be honest, this is an imperfect solution. We all need to take a second look at how we perceive those around us, the judgments we make about their behavior, and the assumptions we make about their life. Because ultimately, the first step to breaking addiction is breaking the stigma. At the beginning of this presentation, I asked you to picture someone who is addicted to drugs. Now it's time to ask yourself, has this picture changed? Thank you.